You are now tuned in to Power Podcasts, the Empower Hour. Peace and blessings, beautiful souls. I am Brandi L. Bates, author of Moonshine for the Soul, The Art of Grind, and many other books. I'll be your host for tonight. You can find me on Twitter at Soledad Francis and on Instagram at Brandi Is Winning. Most of these podcasts can be found archived on YouTube, hashtag Power Podcast, but please listen to them while they still have all of their spirit and vitality and fresh squeezed vitamin C by subscribing to us on iTunes, Spotify, SoundCloud, and or BrandiBates.podomatic.com. You can also find us on Google Play. Nobody gives you power. We're in the cold room. Nobody gives you power. You just take it. I don't care if you are a woman. I don't care if you are a minority. I don't care if you are Latino. I don't care if you are handicapped. I don't care if you have one blue eye. I don't care if you have alopecia. Nobody is going to give you power. You just take it. What does that mean? I'm not trying to sound insensitive, but you will never be able to change how anyone sees you or how anyone perceives you. You'll never be able to control what people think of you or how they feel about you. That comes from them. In fact, everything we do, everything anyone ever does is because of something or things or experiences or circumstances or habits, what you name it, that's going on within them. And so nobody gives you power, and you'll never be able to change another man or another woman. You can't change people. People only change themselves when they're ready. Let's talk about it today. You can't give something that you do not have. You cannot offer up what you have never experienced. We embrace the lifestyles that we know, what we grew up exposed to. If people would simply pay attention to the harmony or disharmony or disjointed thoughts where you have your own hangups and the, we all have an inner hypocrite. All of us. We all have an inner hypocrite. If you find those spots within you where your heart doesn't match up with your mind, your thoughts don't match up with your actions, your goals, where you see yourself, the vision in front of you doesn't match up with the behavior you're exhibiting. Do you follow me? Do you understand can you hear me right now? So if people would simply pay attention to the harmony or disharmony within themselves, they would be able to eliminate all the arduous, impossible task of trying to control the behavior of anybody else. It'll never happen. It'll never happen. People change when they're ready to change. Think about you. Think about your childhood. Think about when you were a teenager. Things that your parents wanted you to do that strictly went against. To this day, so many of you, your parents don't even know who you are. This day, they don't even know you. Have no idea who you truly are behind closed doors, what you're really into. All of your proclivities and your habits. And the ways and the things you into, right? What does your vision consist of? That's something that, like, it's part of the unexamined life is not even tapping into what your vision consists of. The examined life. What does your vision consist of? Because everything that happens to you emerges from your vision. Your vision. And sometimes, though, what you've been pressured into believing is your vision is actually a vision someone else gave to you. There's an ongoing war for your heart and mind. Understand? Do you follow me? Stay with me. Mainstream media. You have all of the social media. You have the apps. You have the Netflix. You have the Hulu. You have the what you're listening to right now, competing with ebooks, competing with a million other podcasts, right? Music you may want to listen to, shit you want to be doing and experiencing, and you want to be here, and you want to, everything is competing for your attention. There is an ongoing war and warfare for your attention, for your heart, for your mind, for your dollars, for your votes, for your energy. And that's because everyone knows that where energy and focus flows, everything else follows that. You are a creator of thought ways on your unique path of joy. No one can limit where you can direct your thought. No one. The one main thing that controls your whole, the lever of your life and the axis of all of your actions is your thought world. And you, and only you, have control over your thought world. You have zero control over a lot of other shit. They can put things in our water, in our drinking water, right? They can put things in the air. They can put things in cyberspace and subliminally program and send out off. But guess what? Guess what? Guess what? Guess what? You have control of what you think, of what you focus on, of what you fixate on, of what you manifest. Literally, no one can stop you but you. And what you allow. So you manifested it all. Everything up to this point, you got you here. It's like Jack Ma said, Jack Ma, the wealthiest man in China, the CEO and founder of Alibaba, he said it. He said, here's the thing, if you're born poor or handicapped or sick or disabled or from the inner city, right? You were born in the project. So you might have been born in a trailer. You might have been born in a double wide, right? That's not of your doing. That wasn't your choice. You didn't get to choose your race. You didn't get to choose the color of your hair. You didn't get to choose your eye color. You didn't get to choose any of that, who your brothers and sisters were going to be. But Jack Ma said, if you're poor at 35, if you're poor at 35, that's your fault. Yeah, that's you. That's you. You can only blame, honestly, I mean, if we're really keeping it, right, we're really keeping it a buck, as you like to say. You can only blame a dysfunctional household or parents who may have been addicts. They may have been abusive or negligent or who just didn't give a damn about you, right? You can only blame that, but for so long. Only but for so long. The rest is all yours. You have to own that. That's you. What do they say? Pull up in that. That's you. Yeah. Everything, including love, hate, suffering, everything needs food to continue. Even a flame needs oxygen. If suffering continues, it's because we are feeding it. Nothing can survive without either oxygen or H2O or food or light, right? If suffering is continuing, at some point you gotta look at what are you allowing? What are you inviting? What are you laying down for? Right? What are you surrendering to? It's because we're feeding it, even if that be unconsciously. Do you realize how much which we sabotage ourselves. At some point, you must take responsibility for you and all of your foibles, idiosyncrasies, faults, gifts, talents. We're all a bag of it all, right? We're all a bag of it all. Good, bad, ugly, messy, shameful, fearful. All of it is all mixed in. Even among the upper echelon. Everyone has their shit, right? Their mess, their darkness, their dark side, their shadow self. And only the wise among us are actually doing the shadow work to deal with and to uproot it, to pull it up out of its roots and deal with it, face it. Look it in the eye. The Tao Te Ching says, one does not walk into the forest and accuse the trees of being off center. Nor do they visit the shore and call the waves imperfect. So why do we look at ourselves the way we look at ourselves? There is a reason why these algorithms are able to read us as humans. And I talked about this before in a previous podcast about the trajectory of AI, artificial intelligence, and VR and virtual reality. And machine learning. And these algorithms, I've said it before, these algorithms know you better than you know yourself. These algorithms know things about you that your parents don't know about you. They know certain things about you that your best friends don't know about you. Because we are configured of built-in, we're made up of built-in habit programs. Everything about your life is a result of a program, a result of a code. And even down to our choices and the next move you take can be figured out like a calculus problem. Your moves can be read like a chess move. You can be read like all of you is coded language. Okay? Herodotus said the worst pain a man can suffer is to have insight into much and power over nothing. As wise as mankind is, we can't seem to stop the atrocities we collectively inflict on the planet. And that's just on a global level. You know, we like to look at problems as though they're outside of us. Those people, that president, right? This country, never us, but we are part and parcel. We are cells in the greater body of the world. You make up your city. Your city makes up your state. Your state makes up your country. Your country makes up this world, right? As wise as mankind is, all this wealth and yet all this poverty. Even in the middle of Central Park, in the middle of Beverly Hills, in the middle of Miami, Florida, in the middle of Bel Air, in the middle of Manhattan, in the middle of Paris, France, in the middle of London, in the center of Johannesburg, in the middle, Rio de Janeiro, all this wealth and yet all this poverty, all this disease, all this suffering, all this food, and abundance, and yet so much famine and starvation just across the pond. Have you ever pondered this? Once you grasp the truth that all things change, there is nothing you will try to hold. Nothing. All reality exists in the mind. There are no limits to your experience. On the path to your happiness, you will discover all that you want to be, all that you want to do, all that you want to have, all that you want to experience. But you have to learn the game. Gotta learn the game. What do I mean? Learn the game. Like, what you would call sometimes being fake is part of knowing the game, playing the game. Fake it till you feel it. Because you have to, where you go physiologically, where you go anatomically, where you go biologically, you go mentally and spiritually and emotionally, and eventually you go there actually. You have to learn to make lucrative moves. You have to learn to understand the bumps in the road. I mean, you gotta apply pressure. You gotta really apply pressure on things in your life sometimes. Am I the only one who studies what defeats me? Sun Tzu said, you have to know your enemy. Like, know them. Like, know them like you know thyself. And you have to know thyself. Full stop. When there is no enemy, there's an ancient African proverb. It says, when there is no enemy within, the enemies outside cannot hurt you. When you right within you, nothing outside you can touch you. It can't faze you. Ships don't sink unless the water gets inside of it. What are you subjecting yourself to? Light and sound alter our DNA. Do you know that? Light and sound alter our DNA and directly influences our biology. Light and sound. Light waves and sound. What are you watching? What are you listening to? What are you exposed to? Who are you hanging with? What are you feeling your attention with? Alters our DNA. DNA is a language, and you can speak to your DNA. You're doing it anyway. You just have never been intentional about it. Everything you want, it's already yours. We're in a code room. Decode it. This is an ancient secret. Everything that you deeply love, everything that you are deeply in love with and desire and are connected to with strong emotion, is deeper than mere, you know, mortal infatuation or desire or lust or hunger. It belongs to you. Regardless of whether you realize it yet or have manifested it yet, there is an inherent ownership of everything you have ever desired, do desire, or will ever desire. Do you follow me? The trick to manifesting what you want is decoded, is to recognize, guess what? That inherent ownership, it's already yours. It's already done. That's why they say fortune follows the bold. You got to be confident. Everybody who has what they want and is winning, they're confident in that. Are they not? Give yourself the love you seek, and the universe will send people who match it. You are the owner of all that you perceive. You have to have the right mindset and the right heart set. You got to get your mind right first. You got to get like laser focus on what it is that you're trying to do and apply pressure to your strategy. And let's just be real. A lot of us have no strategy. We just out here living, just trying to figure it out day to day. You don't know what you're going to eat tomorrow. You don't know what you're going to wear. You don't even know really where you might be in the next year or two. You might still be at that job. You might not, because you just flying by the seat of your ass. You don't know. You know what I mean? You just here and there, whatever works, you know. And but the people who have a strategy and a blueprint, and they're like, this is what I came here to do. And the world will call these people arrogant. The world will call these people cocky. But these people came here with a blueprint. They already know what it is they came here to do. It's better to follow your impulses than to do what, you know, somebody else is telling you to do. That's why I always say, there is no perfect job. There is no such thing as a perfect job, a perfect career. Because it might be the perfect job, but your boss is an asshole, right? It might be you have a great relationship with all of your coworkers, the perfect distance, you know, from your home or what have you. But they don't pay you shit. They're not giving you no promotions. You know, there are no perfect jobs because you have to create it. You have to create your perfect career. You have to create your perfect relationship. You have to build your perfect life. It doesn't just fall out of the sky and fall into place. A lot of you are living your mom's life. Hello? A lot of you living your mom's life. You either following what your parents mapped out for you, or, you know, they wanted you to go to law school. They told you to go to business school. They told you to go into this or go into that. They told you to become a dancer, right? They told you you should be married and have children by a certain age and this, that, and the third. Your parents' life. Or you're just worse. You're blindly following a pattern, i.e. you got pregnant at 16. Your mom got pregnant at 16. Your granny got pregnant at 16. You may be an alcoholic. Your daddy was an alcoholic. And his papa was an alcoholic, right? That's what I mean by blindly following a pattern. You're in the military because your uncle was in the military. And your grandfather was in the military. And you guys are just a military family. But you really don't want to be in the fucking military. But that was what was expected of you, right? You're following a pattern. Decoded. That's coded language. Like computer code programmed into your DNA. I'm trying to make a concept that is very difficult for a lot of people to grasp and understand. And I'm trying to simplify it as distilled virgin olive oil, right? But I found that encouraging and elevating others is the greatest gift you can give yourself. That's the gag. Material things don't mean shit if you're empty inside. That's why there are people have a car collection. They have houses all over the country, all over the world, and yet still empty every night. Still have to snort cocaine or do, you know, pop Valium, pop Prozac because they're depressed. You name it, right? Because material things. A lot of you were fooled into believing if you can just get that car, that house in that neighborhood, right? Get in that particular school, right? Get your kids in a certain academy. Everything will just be right after that. And I'm telling you, it doesn't mean shit if you're empty, if you're inept, if you're void. J. Cole said, what good is bread? What good are the riches if my people are broke? Know this. Something happens when you learn to leave people better than you found them. But so few people get to experience this joy and this pleasure because they're too hung up on the self. That's ego at work. Your ego is like a pimp. Your ego. Got a big ego. E-G-O. Your ego is like a pimp. Because you do all the work. You have to experience all the suffering. You have to experience all of the weariness and exhaustion and get beat up by life. But the ego gets all the glory. And so when you only and exclusively do things for yourself without ever putting forth intention on helping to uplift or to edify or to build someone else, you miss out on untold miracles. And it doesn't even have to be all deep. And, you know, it could just be the blue collar worker who is excited about the work that they do because they get to serve people. It's the lady at the church or the old man who comes and picks up trash at the park, right? It's the bus driver who decides to bring Valentine's cards to all the kids who ride on his bus, right? It's the garbage man, right? Who does just does the little extra effort because he cares about the people that he serves. All the really super rich, super wealthy understand this concept. That's why those who have the most give the most. And then they just keep getting more and are able to give more. And it just keeps perpetuating itself. See, you were told the more you give, the more you will receive. But you didn't really examine what that means on a soul level, on a karmic level. We've all met those souls who, even when they have nothing, they don't have a pot, they don't have a window, but they will take the shirts off their backs and give that if that's all they have to give. I know people who, they can be down and out and have a candy bar. And if you say you're hungry, they will cut that candy bar in half and give you the other half. Because that's just what's in them. It's really, really real. The more you give, the more you receive. And it sounds almost juvenile. Almost juvenile in simplicity. And yet, it's a deep concept that many of us simply miss. Goes right over our heads. Remember when you put up walls, you might succeed at keeping certain elements of society out, but you also equally keep a lot of the good shit out. You keep out the potential for love. You keep out the potential for so many different elements that cannot reach you because you have a wall up. You will never experience next level, next stratosphere love unless and until you've shown yourself vulnerable. Totally, 1000%. Yeah, you risk getting hurt. You do risk getting hurt. And that's why most of us put up walls, because we're like, fuck that. I'm not trying to get hurt. For what? But when you erect the walls, you hold out all of the rich experiences. Just like things can potentially hurt you, things can potentially take you to the next level. But you got a wall up. Real artists don't starve. Contrary to popular belief, real artists don't starve. Meaning, as long as you're doing what you love, what you're passionate about, you will be enriched and edified in that. I'm not talking about what you do every day to pay the rent or to pay your car note or to pay your credit card bills and your student loans or you name it, right? What are you passionate about? As long as that passion keeps your fire lit, eventually you get good at it. And you get so good at it that it activates something within you lying dormant. And that's when you enter rare air. And eventually, this is what makes room for your for all of your blessings. This is what makes room for your come up. This is what makes room for the book deal or the record deal or the movie deal or the bid at the auction. This is what gets you put on the map. This is what gets you the contracts. This is what gets you in the right rooms with the real movers and shakers and the real influencers. This is what has you trending. This is what brings you the coin. Do you follow me? Who you are today, that might change 180 degrees in the next 20 years. You're not going to always be who you are right now. Because if we're being real, if we're keeping it real, you used to be somebody else. Who you are today will change in 7 years. You can take that check to the bank. What you're into right now, some of it in the next 10 years, some of it you'll still be into, but most of it won't even hold your attention anymore. Have you ever looked back, just look back at old pictures, like what was I thinking? Have you ever looked back at an ex, like, wow, I was really tripping, right? But rejection, whether that's rejection in you didn't get the job, or you didn't get the audition, you didn't get the call back, you didn't get the promotion. This person stepped out on you. They chose someone else. They moved on. Rejection. Rejection is just the redirection to your soul's highest calling. Period. Full stop. Be brave enough to be bad at something new. There are still so many parts of you that you have yet to know or even understand. And for a lot of you, that's not going to register for a couple months. There are still experiences in front of you that will teach you that you are so much stronger than you realize you are. There are things you will experience later down the line that pull something out of you that you did not even know you had. You don't know what you're made of until you run up against those things built into the code of your journey, only to make you stronger, wiser, or better. Thank you so much for your presence, your essence, and your time, and most importantly, your attention. Stay uplifted in power and love. Metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot you.